If you want to get the best from the plants in your garden, then you really need to know what the soil is that you're growing them on. And one of the most important things to understand is what the pH of that soil is. Now, pH is a grade between acid and alkaline. In soil terms, it runs from around about pH 4, pH 4.5, you can see on this scale, right the way up to around about pH 7.5 to 8. Naturally, the soils in the UK don't extend much beyond that range. So once you've decided that you want to test your soil for pH, then it's a matter of going out and getting yourself a pH testing kit. Now, there are some very simple ones on the market like this. This comes with two tubes that you have a tablet in with the test solution in, and it will give you a colour result that you can read off this very simple chart at the side. But that's not really very technologically advanced. So if you go for one like this, this is a more advanced soil test kit. It enables you to test not just for pH, but also for soil nutrients as well along here. This comes in at around about £20. So the first thing to do is to collect a sample of soil from your garden. Go to different points, say the four corners of your garden, and collect perhaps a trowelful from each point. Mix it together in a large pot or a bucket. Then take one trowelful sample and put it out in the sunshine and allow that soil to dry so that we've got this dusty texture to it. So once you've got your sample, it's simply a matter of taking the test tube and you want to fill it up to the 1 millilitre mark. So just put a little bit of the soil into the test tube, tap it down, and that's ready then for the barium sulfate powder. This is the powder that changes the colour of the soil sample and indicates whether it reacts with the soil sample, indicates whether it's acid or alkaline. So you just need a small amount of that. They provide you with a little spoon. Take a level spoonful, tap it into the top of the container there like that. Make sure that you put the top back on the barium sulfate because you don't want it blowing around and blowing away. Put the little spoon away. And then you take the pH testing solution here and you add up to the 2.5 graduation on the side of the test tube. So look for the 2.5 mark, fill it up with the solution. It's about right. Make sure you put the top back on. Put the cap onto the test tube and then give it a jolly good shake. And then leave it to one side to develop, and we'll come back to that one in a minute. I've got some samples that I tested from some other soils from other people's gardens. I've brought those along. I've got one here to show you what happens when you've got an acid soil. So that's around about pH 5.5. So that's quite strongly acid. That's suitable for rhododendrons, camellias, pieris, those sorts of things. And then if we compare that to this other sample, this was from an area of chalk downland, and you can see that this is a very dark green here, right up at the top end of the pH scale. So that means that it's great for growing vegetables and fruit. Now, if your soil is very acid and you want to grow lots of veg, then you can add lime to your soil and that will increase the pH, bring the pH level up. But unfortunately, if your pH is very high, it's a very alkaline soil, unfortunately, there's not a lot you can do about it. You can read in books that you can add sulfur to your soil, but that really, you need to add such a huge amount that it's not economically viable. So let's return to our sample that we tested. You can see that that's roughly working out at about pH 7. So that's dead where it needs to be. That's the ideal pH level for growing a huge range of plants. That means you can get away with growing rhododendrons and azaleas and acid-loving plants, but you can also grow alkaline-loving plants as well. So there we are, that's an ideal soil. These other two, perhaps they need a bit more work on them to get them up to scratch.